Hey, my name is Steve. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I will cover the 2018 HSC Mathematics Extension 1 past paper from question 6 to question 10. So here's question 6. The question is, the diagram shows the graph of the function y equals to fx. So here's the graph for the function fx. The equation of fx equal to 0 has a solution at x equal to w at this point. So the Newton's method can be used to give another approximation close to the solution of x equal to w, which initial approximation x1 will give the second approximation that is closest to the solution of x equal to w at this point. So actually, we are consider these a, b, c, d, these four values to getting a closest second approximation by the Newton's law to this value, w. Okay, I'll clean up some area to explain this question. Okay. Because for the Newton's method, we have the second approximation x2 equals the first approximation x1 minus the function at x1 divided by the differentiation of the function at x1. To find the solution for this question, we can starting from the tangent equation of the function at these four points. Okay, the equation for the tangent line would be y equals fx1. So y, so we have a function, we have a formula for y equal to y0 equal to the gradient times x minus x0, right? We are using this one. So here is the value of the function at x1 equal to the differentiation of the function at x1. So here's the gradient of the function at x1 and then times x minus x1. Okay, we can rearrange a little bit this equation. We have x minus x1 equal this part will be this part divided by this one, right? We have y minus fx1 divided by the differential of x1. And then we bring the x1 to the outside. We have the x equal to x1 plus y minus fx1 divided by the differential of the function at x1. Okay, look at this equation. If y equal to 0, which means we are having the x intersection. If y equal to 0, which means we are having x equal to x1, we bring this negative to here minus the function at x1 divided by the differentiation of the function at x1. And this part is exactly the same to the Newton's method for the second approximation, right? In this equation, actually this x is the x-intersection, which means the tangent line cutting with the x-axis. We are looking for this x2 getting close to this w, which means if this x close to this w, right, then we can consider these four points a b c d to see which one can give this x closest to this w. Then we can say one of these points can give a better, the best second approximation to the w. Okay, let's look at the gradient of at these four points. For this one, the gradient lines roughly cutting at this point at x-axis, right? This one cannot cut with the x-axis, and also the same thing to D. And for C, is cutting with the x-axis at here. So compare this one A, B, C, D. Only the A and C can have an x-intersection. Obviously, this point is closest to the W, which means we can say the point C, or the value of C, can give a second approximation closest to the value or to the root. Then the answer for this question is C point. Then C. Okay. Then let's go to question 7. The question is, the velocity of a particle in meters per second is given by the v equal to x squared plus 2, where x is displacement in meters from the origin. The question is, what's the acceleration of the particle at x equal to 1? Okay, so we have, if x is the function for the displacement, then we have dx over dt, which means we're doing the derivative of x with respect to t. Here's the v, right? The velocity. If we're keeping another differentiation of dv over dt is the acceleration, right? Then if dA equal to dv over dt, but here we don't have the function for v in terms of t, but we are having the function for v in terms of x, which means we are using the chain rule for dv over dx, and then times dx over dt, right? This part actually is dv over dt. This dx over dt actually is v, right? Here, dv over dx, we can do the differentiation to v with respect to x, okay? Then here, dv over dx, the differential of this equation is 2x. And then times dx over dt, actually just v. We can bring this v into here to have x squared plus 2. Now we are having the function for acceleration in terms of x. Then we can find the acceleration for the particle at x equal to 1, which means we can submit this x equal to 1 into this equation to have a at x equal to 1 equal to 2 times 1 times 1 squared plus 2 equal to 2 times 1 plus 2, 3 equal to 6. For the acceleration is 6 meters per second per second. So 6 meters times s seconds to the power of negative 2. So the answer would be C. This one, C.
Okay, let's go to question 8. 6 men and 6 women are to be seated at a round table. So here we have a round table with 12 seats for 6 men and 6 women. In how many different ways can they be seated if men and women alternate? So first of all, if this one for men, so this one would be has to be a one of woman. Man, woman, man, woman, man, woman, just like that, right? Let's consider the man first. If totally we have 6 chairs for the man, so the total different number of arrangement for men is 6 factorial. But we are having a circular arrangement, which means we have to divide it by 6 to eliminate the overcount of the arrangement. For example, because here's a circular arrangement, we shift, turn off the table another angle, they have the same orders, okay? So we have to divide it by 6. Once the man so this one is for men. Once the man seated have been fixed, the other 6 seats for the women can be 6 factorial of the total number of arrangement for women. Okay? 6 factorial divided by 6 is 5 factorial. And this 6 factorial, 6 factorial. Then we are having the answer is B. Okay? And we can do this question in another way. For example, we can fix one man for this chair or one of them. We can fix one chair for one man. Right? Then we still have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We still have 5 chairs for the other 5 men. So for the other 5 men, the total arrangement is 5 factorial, right? Okay, when the men are all the men are fixed, then the women still have 6 chairs. Then 5 factorial times 6 factorial. So this 5 factorial is for the other 5 men. This 6 factorial is for all the 6 women. So totally, we have the same answer, 5 factorial times 6 factorial. We have the same. You can do this way or either this way. Okay? Okay, let's go to question 9. In question 9, which of the following is the general solution? So general solution to the equation of sine 2x equals to negative half. For general solution, we can have find this formula at the end of the past paper. If sine theta equals to a, then the general solution for theta is n pi plus negative 1 to the power of n times the sine inverse a. Okay, using this formula compared to this one, we have theta equal to this 2x, which means we have 2x equal to n pi plus negative 1 to the power of n sine inverse of this a. We are having a equal to negative half. Then this 2x equal to n pi plus negative 1 to the power of n. This value is negative pi on 6. Okay, so the inverse value for half, for sine negative half, is 2x. Then x is, we can divide it by 2 on the both sides of the equation. We have n pi divided by 2 plus, we can combine this negative to this negative side, to this negative 1, to have negative 1 and plus 1. Okay, we bring in this negative combined with this negative 1 to have to the power of negative 1 and plus 1. And then times, and then we still have pi on 6 left. So pi on 6 divided by 2. Then we have pi on 12. So at the end, we are having x equal to n pi divided by 2 plus negative 1 to the power of n plus 1. And then times pi on 12. Okay? And we see which one can match the answer. D. So n pi divided by 2 plus negative 1 to the power of n plus 1 pi on 2. Yep. So the final answer is D. Okay, let's go to question 10. A particle is moving in a simple harmonic motion. The displacement of the particle is x, and its velocity, v, is given by this equation, v squared equal to n squared times 2kx minus x squared, where n and k are constants. So this n and k are two constants. The particle is initially at x equal to k. The final question is, which function over here, in terms of time t, could represent the motion of the particle? So far, we are having two information from the questions. One of this one, for the equation of v. The other information is, the particle is initially at x equal to k. Right, because in simple harmonic motion, the velocity at two end points is zero, which means here is the center at negative k and k. At this point, the velocity equal to zero. At this point, the velocity equal to zero as well. Right, if we make this equation equal to zero, we can find the value for x, which means this x is these two endpoints, right? Then we can find the displacement of the particle where v equal to zero, which means where the velocity is equal to zero. We make v squared equal to n squared 2kx minus x squared equal to zero. Then we can divide by n on both sides, which means cross out the n square. So it doesn't matter what the n is. We have x and x squared. We can factor out 1x, 1x of x times 2k minus x, and then equal to 0. Right? For this one, we have x1 equal to 0. For here, we have x2 equal to 2k, which means the particle is moving from 0 to 2k. These two endpoints, and also we have another condition is that the particle is initially at x equal to k. So here is k. Here is the center of the motion. So the particle is moving from here to here and back to in this range, from 0 to k. So which means the x, so in the range of 0 to 2k. So we are looking for the range for the x is from 0 to 2k. Okay? We can look at these four equations to see whether one of them can meet this condition. First of all, A, for cos nt, the value is from negative 1 to 1, which means the range for x is from negative k to k, right? This one doesn't meet this condition, 0 to 2k, which means A should not be the answer. Next one, go to B. So sine nt also is from negative 1 to 1. So here, if negative 1, so negative k plus k is 0. Negative positive 1 times k is k. So k plus k, we have 2k. Which means this x is in the range between 0 and 2k. B should be the answer. If you're not sure, then let's go to check the C and D as well with the same method. For example, this cos nt also is from negative 1 to 1, which means the range for the x is negative 3k to positive 2k minus k, we have k. So at C, the range for x is negative 3k to k. Doesn't meet the condition of the question, right? So C is not the answer. The same thing to D, sine nt also is from negative 1 to 1, which means the range for x is negative 1, negative 2k plus k, we have negative k, to positive 2k plus k, 3k. In D, the range for x is negative k to 3k. It doesn't meet the condition of the question, right? Then D is wrong. B is the only answer can meet this condition for the question, which means D must be the answer. Yep, that'll be all for the questions 6 to 10 in the 2018 HSC Mathematics Extension 1 past paper. In the next video, I've covered the question 11 in the same paper. Hopefully, my videos will help you to have a much preparation for your HSC exam. If you like my video, please give it a like and subscribe my channel. Okay? I'll see you in next video. Bye-bye.